Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Truvy's. I hope you're going to enjoy the show tonight. The girls have been working very, very hard. You know, I can't see anything with this light on. Is anybody here? Oh, there they are. How are you? In case of an emergency, there are clearly marked exit signs behind you, this way, and the way you came in. Just don't run over the actors if we're all leaving in a big hurry, okay? Put your cell phones on vibrate, or better yet, turn them off. There's nothing that can't wait till the show is over. We're gonna serve refreshments in the courtyard. We'll have water and we'll have snacks. However, one stipulation, we can't bring it into the building, which is why we're serving you in the courtyard. The story of Steel Magnolias is a very famous movie, but what people don't realize is that the play takes place in one place, Truvy Shop. I hope you'll enjoy the show.
Oops, I see a hole. I was hoping you'd catch that. It's a little poofier than I would normally do, but I'm nervous.
Oh, I'm not too concerned about that. When I go to bed at night, I wrap my entire head in toilet tissue, so it gets a little poofed down in that process.
In my class at the trade school, I was number one when it came to frosting and streaking. I did my own.
Really? I wouldn't know, and I can spot a bottle job at 20 paces. Well, your technique is good, and your form and content will improve with experience. So you're hired. Oh. And not a moment too soon. This morning we're going to be busier than a one-arm paper hanger.
Thank you, Miss Truvy. Thank you.
No time. Now, you know where the coffee is, and everything else is over there by the stove.
Oh, let me help you. You've got little tiny hairs and fuzzies all over you.
Honey, there's so much static electricity in here, I pick up everything except boys and money. Be a treasure. Annelle, this is the most successful shop in town. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Because I have a strict philosophy that I've stuck to for the last 15 years. Do you know what it is? There's no such thing as natural beauty. That's why I've never lost a client to the cut and curl or the beauty shop. Do not scrimp on anything. My ladies get only the best. Feel free to use as much hairspray as you like.
Thing is natural beauty.
Remember that, Annelle. It takes some effort to look like this. Just look at me.
I can see that. How many ladies do we have this morning?
Well, I restrict myself to the ladies of the neighborhood on Saturday mornings. Normally that would be just three. But today we have Shelby Eatonton. She's not a regular. She's the daughter of a regular. I have to do something special with her hair. She's getting married this afternoon. Now, Annelle, how long have you been in town?
A few weeks.
New in town. Oh, that must be exciting. I wouldn't know. I've lived here all my life.
It's a little scary.
I can imagine. Now tell me things about yourself.
There's nothing to tell. I live here. I've got a job now. That's it. Could I borrow a few of these back issues of Southern Hair?
Sure. It's important to take an interest in the latest fashions. I'm glad to see you're taking an interest. I've got Ladies Home Journal, Glamour, Cosmopolitan. I've got every magazine known to man. Now, Annelle, you must live close by, within walking distance. I mean, I didn't see a car.
My car? I don't have a car. I live across the river at Robeline's boarding house.
Oh, that's quite a walk. Ruth Robeline. Now there's a story. She's a twisted, troubled soul. Her life has been an experiment in terror. Her husband was killed in World War II. Her son was killed in Vietnam. When it comes to suffering, she's right up there with Elizabeth Taylor.
I had no idea.
Oh.
Is that a gunshot?
Yes, I believe it is. Go plug in the hot tank, dear. Hot plate.
But why is someone firing a gun in a nice neighborhood like this?
It's a long story. It has to do with Shelby's wedding and her father. You'd be happy if you just ignored it like the rest of the neighborhood. Morning, Clairee. I tried to call you, but there was no answer.
I was out at the high school. I was out at the crack of dawn.
Oh, And now, come and meet the former First Lady of Chuinquin, Mrs. Belcher. Clairee, this is Annelle. It's her first day.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, I'm a little embarrassed. If I had known I was meeting new people, I would have taken a little more pride in my appearance. I've been at the dedication of our new football field. Oh. I'm not always this windblown.
Then name the new stadium after her late husband, Lord Belcher Memorial Coliseum. They've awarded her all sorts of special titles.
I have the pom-poms to prove it. What was your name, dear?
Oh, well, my married name's Dupree.
I don't believe I know any Duprees.
I just moved here. I'm originally from Zwali.
Oh, well, that explains it. Truvy, I thought I brought you those recipes.
Well, the reason I called is, do you mind if I do Shelby first?
That's fine. Shelby's the most important one today. Oh, that man, Aswani, I think the situation is worse than ever.
Annelle, we're gonna need some more towels. They're stacked up over there by the washing machine.
Sweet girl, where'd you find her?
Well, she heard I had an opening and she just walked in the door. I think there's a story here.
What makes you say that?
Well, for one thing, she's married, but she's living at Ruth Robeline's alone.
You better get to the bottom of this. You have some nice silverware you'd like to keep.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. She's very nice. I just like the idea of hiring someone with a past.
She can't be more than 20. She hasn't had time to have a past.
Honey, it's the 80s. If you can achieve puberty, you can achieve a past. Yuck. Annelle, how did you make this coffee?
Like you said, I poured hot water through the thing.
Where did you get the hot water?
It was boiling on the stove.
Did you not notice the hot dogs at the bottom of the pot?
No.
Make some more, please.
I'm so sorry.
Don't worry, I love a good hot dog, but not with cream and sugar.
Oh, well, she's not an international spy, but if she works out, I might let her rent the garage apartment.
I thought the twins were going to live there while they go to college.
Recent development. Lou is going to LSU, and Poots decided to go work for my cousin in Baltimore. And he doesn't want to be called Poot anymore. My babies are growing up.
I can't believe your kids are old enough to leave the nest.
Well, you know I was a child bride. Well, I look on the bright side. At least I have places to visit now. I've always wanted to go to Baltimore. I hear it's the head and capital of the world.
Here they are. I'm so fat I couldn't feel them.
Oh, the recipes. Let me see. Oh, these look delicious.
It is, and the Bisquick makes it so simple. And this one is for my daughter-in-law. She says you can't attend a function in Tickfall where that's not served.
Now, are the chocolate chips here, are they semi-sweet or milk?
They're milk.
And the carousel, is it light or dark?
No matter of taste.
About that one you were telling me about. Oh, what was it? The cup of.
Oh, yeah. That's so easy, you don't even have to write it down. Cup of flour, cup of sugar, cup of fruit cocktail with the juice, mix it up and bake at 350 till golden bubbly.
That sounds awful sweet.
It is. So I serve it over ice cream to cut the sweetness. Give me some paper. I'll copy them down for you.
Annelle, get Clarice some paper. There's some over there on the frigidaire, underneath the crawfish. Oh, and have you seen the article on Lady Di? Oh, sometimes I swear Drum Eaton's brain doesn't get enough oxygen. That is so annoying.
Try living next door to him.
Oh. Hi, everybody. There she is. There's my girl. Come hug my neck.
Hi, Truvy. Morning, Miss Clairee. It's not that I'm unfriendly. I'm just worried about my nails.
Oh, that's a pretty color.
I hope it doesn't dry too dark. If it's too dark, it'll never do. You know the colors are never the same on the bottle.
You'll always find that to be true.
This is drying way too dark, practically pink, my foot. Truly, do you have any of those nail polish remover things?
Let me see. Where's your mama?
Right behind me, I thought. Hi, I'm Shelby Eatonton, soon to be Lattery.
Hi, I'm Annelle.
This is Annelle's first day.
Well, Annelle, you're working with the best. Anybody who's anybody gets their hair done at Truby's.
Absolutely. Oh, Shelby, you know I would walk on my lips to avoid criticizing anyone, but your father's gonna make us all pull our hair out, and that is bad for my business.
Well, he should be finished with his yard work pretty soon.
I hope so.
You're not the only one concerned. He and Mama are fighting like cats and dogs.
They're just anxious.
anxious with so much going on.
No, they're not. They're just trying to create as much tension as possible in any given situation. It's a creed they live by.
You know, I was reading an article in Glamour about tension during family situations. It seems like there can be a lot of stress and trauma, and that stress and trauma can cause your hair to fall out.
They're fighting about patio furniture. Jackson and I will never fight about silly little things. Are you married, Annelle?
Oh, I sure hope that coffee's better.
It smells right.
Oh, how pretty.
Princess Grace.
Oh, you brought me the picture like I asked you to.
Here you go. Study it carefully. And here's the baby's breath.
Oh, this is beautiful. I feel like I'm present at the creation. There's something so wondrous about how a bride looks. I feel like it's beauty in its purest form. Where are you gonna put this? There's no baby breath in this picture.
You just stick it in. It's meant to frame my face. Baby's breath is part of my whole decoration concept for a total romantic look.
Oh, Miss Clairee, what cute shoes!
You think so? I don't know. I think they're a little too racy for me. I might give them away.
Well, those are too cha-cha for words. If you decide not to keep them, I'll buy them from you.
What size do you wear?
Well, in a good shot, I wear 6. But a 7 feels so good, I buy a size 8.
The rate in the house.
Perfect.
Hi, Mama. Look at Miss Clary's shoes.
They're mine.
Annelle, this is Mama. Mama, how are things at the house?
Fine. Ouiser drove stopped by just a second to talk to your father. One of both of them is probably lying in a pool of blood by now.
Did you say your name?
Hi. That's a pretty name. It's unusual. I'm Leanne.
How's the mother of the bride?
Don't ask.
What happened?
Nothing that a handful of prescription drugs couldn't take care of.
I'll take that for you.
Thank you. Just put it over there. Who's going to do my hair, Truvy?
Oh, Annelle. Go on and shampoo, Miss Eatonton. These girls have mountains to move today.
Ain't that the truth?
They'll come for your cards right up there.
Mama.
Oh, this cake.
This color is all wrong. It looks like a stuck pig bled all over my hands.
I'm sure I have something back at the house that'll do.
But do you have pink?
Of course I have pink.
It has to be delicate.
If I don't have something that'll do, we'll send one of the boys out to get you some delicate pink nail polish.
Great idea, Mama. I'd love to see what Tommy pick out.
Is there anything I can do to help out last minute?
Oh, no, you've done plenty, Clairee. We just finished everything up. You know, we just finished borrowing every fern in North Louisiana. Boys got in last night, and they're taking care of the odds and ends.
I hope the rain holds off. I'm sorry it's not a prettier day.
Oh, this is perfect weather for me. I don't function well when it's hot. I love cloudy days. On cloudy days, I feel like God's not trying very hard, so I don't have to either.
She does sweat profusely.
Thank you, Mama.
I don't mind the heat. I love it. But spicy food makes me sweat. Right on the top of my head, my hair gets all wet.
I get it. I bet that's for me. It's probably my mind trying to locate my body.
Hello? Yes, sir, she is. Hold on a minute. The lady's your husband.
Yes, Drum? I don't know. I don't have it. I said I don't have it. Drum, if you were trying to drive me crazy, you are too late for that. Now, for the last time, I don't have it. Ask one of the boys. Goodbye, Drum.
What Daddy want?
Nothing.
So, Shelby, we want to sweep it up, but leave some softness around your ears.
Sweep it up?
Yes, Mama, up, like Princess Grace.
Did you give Truvy that picture of Jack and Smith?
No, I gave her the picture of Princess Grace. I destroyed the picture of Jacqueline Smith.
But I thought I made you understand the advantages of a Jacqueline Smith hairdo.
No, Mama.
Well, at least I talked her out of that stupid idea, sticking all that baby's breath in her hair.
Keep your head in the sink, please.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. I find cool water refreshing.
It just startled me a little, that's all.
Truvy, can I copy your recipe for strawberry pie?
Sure. Shelby, your mama doesn't tell us much. What is Jackson like?
Oh, he's pretty swell. I thought he was a pest at first, but then he kind of grew on me. And now I love him.
Well, where'd you meet him?
At a party at the Petroleum Club in Shreveport. I didn't know who he was at first, but I was getting a real big kick out of watching him on the dance floor. It was painfully obvious he had never taken the time to watch himself dance in front of a mirror. There was something so romantic about how stupid he looked.
Is he real romantic?
No, but he does make me flowers and little presents if I bug him enough. He has promised to give me a red rose on every anniversary corresponding to that number anniversary. I think that's so sweet.
Well, that's a pretty romantic idea, isn't it?
Yes. I wish it had been his.
Lloyd and I missed it to 50 years by 3 months. That stinker. Bless his heart. He tried. He just couldn't hold on.
Do you remember your wedding, Miss Clairee?
Of course I do. I remember everything. The flowers, the food. Ouiser was my maid of honor. Shelby, I hope you and Jackson will be as happy as Lloyd and I were. We had such a good time. Until last November, but at least he hung on through the state playoffs.
There are still good times to be had.
Oh, sure. But I miss the whirlwind of being a mayor's wife. It's not easy being just one. I don't like going to things by myself. If I go with a couple, I'm a third wheel. If I go with another friend, we're just a couple of old biddies.
Well, somebody like you should be able to find something to occupy your time.
Well, I really do love football, but it's hard to parlay that into a reason to live.
Ouiser, let's face it. You are a woman coming to terms with her grips. You and I are in the same situation. My kids are leaving town. My husband hasn't got up from that sofa in 15 years. It's up to us to figure out what our purpose on this earth is. Well, that's my sermon. Now, Shelby, are you and Jackson going to live in West Monroe or Monroe proper?
Oh, Monroe, of course. His law practice is there.
You are so lucky, Shelby. Louisiana lawyers do well whether they want to or not.
Oh, I don't really care. I mean, don't get me wrong, the money's real nice. But I just like the idea of growing old with somebody. My dream is to get old and sit on the back porch coveting grandchildren and say, no, stop that.
Are you going to quit nursing?
Never. I love it. I love being around all those babies. Last week, we had this poor little fella, 2.5 months premature. I kept holding him and talking to him, but I knew he wasn't going to make it.
That is so sad. Happens all the time.
Drum and I feel that Shelby should not continue to work after she gets married.
I am so anxious to discuss this topic for the 900th time this week.
You shouldn't be on your feet all day. You should be kind to your circulatory system.
Annelle, I know you're new and all, but don't ever let that stop you. If you have anything to say, you just let it rip.
I don't have anything to say.
Malin, it looks like you're ready to roll. Annelle, do you think you can roll Mrs. Eaton tonight?
I don't know. Today is very special, and my work tends to be too poofy when I'm nervous. Does your dress have to go over your head?
You can't screw up her head. You just tease it, make it look like a football helmet.
I must have missed the passage in Emily Post that said all abuse must be heaped upon the mother of the bride. Go ahead, Annelle.
I'm sure you'll do a beautiful job. Don't matter what I look like anyway.
Hush, girls. Tell me about the wedding. How many bridesmaids?
9.
Good Lord.
Exactly.
Well, I hope the photographer brings a wide-angle lens.
I think it's embarrassing and awful, but Mama made me have my cousins and Marjorie St. Maurice.
Shelby, there's no way around it, and you know it.
It'll be pretentious, and Daddy always says, an ounce of pretension is worth a pound of manure.
The poet laureate of Dogwood Lane.
I wish you'd get off Daddy's back. He gets enough hassle from Miss Ouiser.
What do you call us, Shelby?
Flush and bashful.
The colors are pink and pink.
Flush and bashful.
How much more precious is this wedding gonna get, I ask you?
My colors are blush and bashful. I have chosen 2 shades of pink. One is much deeper than the other.
But the bridesmaids' dresses are really beautiful.
Oh, and the ceremony will be too. All the walls are banked with sprays of flowers in the 2 shades of blush and bashful. There's a pink carpet specially laid for the ceremony, and pink silk button draped over anything that would stand still.
The sanctuary looks like it's been hosed down with Pepto-Bismol.
I like pink!
I tried to get her to use peaches and cream. That would be so lovely this time of year. All the azaleas in our yard are peach-colored. Peach is flattering on every skin tone.
No way. Pink is my signature color.
What color's your dress, Malin?
Peach and cream.
Clairee?
Beige lace to the knee.
Well, I'm going to be wearing a sexy blue chiffon. Shelby, Jackson's going to take one look at me and leave you behind in the dust.
But Mama's dress is gorgeous. It cost more than my wedding dress.
Oh, it did not. It was on sale.
That's what she told Daddy. What she actually meant was it was for sale, not on sale.
Hello? Janice, you know I can't do that today. I'm dealing with Shelby. I know it's an emergency, but tomorrow's Sunday. Oh, all right, come on in after church.
Truly, you should not give up your Sundays.
Well, you know how vain Janice Van Meter is about her appearance.
And now, Janice is the current mayor's wife. We hate her.
Fill us in on the reception, Shelby.
There's going to be ferns and twinkling lights. There'll be magnolias in the pool.
Oh, I just hope your father doesn't get magnolias from Ouiser's side of the tree. We will never hear the end of it.
The wedding cake will be by the pool. And the groom's cake will be hidden in the carport.
Shelby and I agree on one thing.
The groom's cake. It's awful. It's in the shape of a giant armadillo.
An armadillo?
Jackson wanted a cake in the shape of an armadillo. He has an aunt that makes them.
That's unusual.
It's repulsive. It's got gray icing. I can't even begin to think how you'd make gray icing.
Worse, the cake pot is red velvet cake. Blood red. People are going to be hacking into this animal that looks like it's bleeding to death.
The rehearsal supper was an experience.
It wasn't that bad. It was out at Jackson's uncle's place on the river.
They served steak and baked potatoes. They went to a lot of trouble.
They liked to barbecue.
For dessert, they served an original creation called Dago Pie. I think that explains it all. Jackson comes from a good old Southern family with good old Southern values. You either shoot it, stuff it, or marry it.
They're simply outdoorsy, that's all. Well, did you two do anything particularly romantic?
We drove down to Frenchman's Point and went parking.
Oh, Shelby, really?
Ooh, the romantic part? That is what really melts my butter.
Then we went skinny dipping and did things that frighten the fish.
Shelby.
It's been a long time since we've had a youngster in this place, hasn't it?
And we talked and talked and talked.
I love those kind of talks. In the arms of the man you loved.
Actually, we fought most of the time.
What?
Because I told him I couldn't marry him.
What?
Why would you go and do a thing like that?
It's okay now. We worked it all out.
Well, it must have just been one of those last-minute jitter things.
No. Put the wedding still on.
Well, that's good, because this is going to be in the Hairdo Hall of Fame.
You scared us, Shelby. That was not a nice thing to do to your mama. You should never say something like that to a woman who's marinating 50 pounds of crab claw.
You know, making up can be so romantic. I miss romance so much, I'm jealous.
Oh, Truvy, it can't be that bad.
The last romantic thing my husband did for me was in 1972. He enclosed this carport so that I could support him. Very nice, Annelle. I think you know what you're doing.
Thank you. Mrs. Eaton, you have great hair, and your scalp's as clean as a whistle.
I try.
Well, it must run in the family. Shelby, your hair is so thick and pretty. Hold your head up. Shelby!
Stop
it! Malin!
Oh, honey. Truvy, there's some candy in my purse.
I've got a peppermint right here.
Oh, Shelby, we're getting you some juice.
Do you need a cookie?
Here's the juice. Shelby, you need some juice. Here.
Leave me alone.
Please, honey, drink the juice.
No.
You can blame her juice after a peppermint?
Mama, stop it. I have candy in my purse.
Shelby, you didn't bring your purse. Here, have a sip. Oh, God, there's no wonder with all this wedding nonsense and running around.
Excuse me, should I call a doctor or
no,
something?
No.
Shelby's a diabetic.
Come on. Mom, she's got a little too much insulin in her, that's all. She'll be all right if I could just get her to drink some.
Drink. I'm gonna leave if you don't leave me alone.
I'd love to see you try. Cooperate, Shelby. Drink.
Please drink the juice, honey.
There we go. That's better.
That one hit her quick.
She's on the pill, and her hormones have been running wild. She'll get on an even keel pretty soon.
She could hurt herself, Malin. What if this happened when she was driving a car?
I guess that explains why I have so much gray hair. But you've known Shelby as long as I have. You know I have to let her be strong. She doesn't seem to be down too deep.
Talk to her, Shelby?
No.
That's good enough.
She's been so upset lately. Her and Jackson have been going round and round. Dr. Mitchum told her at a last appointment, children aren't possible. It wasn't the easiest thing in the world to sit there and watch your child's heart break.
Don't talk about me like I'm not here.
There you are. You're making some sense. This one was not bad at all, okay? I think you need a little more juice.
Can I do something? Should I?
No, no. She'll be fine in just a few minutes. She probably won't remember anything. Don't fuss over her. Normality is very important to Shelby.
I'm sorry about the children, Pomeline.
I know. She thinks that Jackson might be throwing away his chances at children. I mean, they've discussed it, and he seems to have taken it all right. Shelby's the one who's pushing it.
He said, shut up. Don't be stupid. There's plenty of kids out there that need good homes. We'll adopt 10 of them. We'll buy them if we have to.
Jackson sounds like good people to me.
He does. I knew right then and there that if he was dumb enough to spend the rest of his life with me, then I was dumb enough to marry him. Oh. Oh, gosh. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Mama.
Hello. Yes, honey. Just a second. Shelby. Malin, it's Tommy for Shelby.
Oh, Shelby, it's Tommy. Oh.
Shelby, he wants to know where your car is.
Absolutely not. That's the honeymoon getaway car. He just wants to defile it. Jackson said he's been driving by and rubbers by the case.
She's gonna have to call you back.
Thank you, Mama.
Well, sit up straight. I've got to gild the lily. Now, are you gonna be taken down at the reception? I don't mind giving you a touch-up before the honeymoon.
Oh, no, I'm gonna leave it up as long as possible.
So the honeymoon, let me guess. I picture somewhere tropical, secluded, oh, moonlit for days. Somewhere you can be intimate out of doors.
Las Vegas.
Oh, I hear the weather's nice. I hear it's like living in a blow dryer.
Shelby, about what Jackson said.
I'd rather not talk about it, Mama. What happens in my life now is between Jackson and me. Jackson will take care of me, and I'll take care of him.
You can't blame people for being concerned about you, darling.
About what Jackson said. About adoption, it was wonderful. And very wise. Not being able to have children is no disgrace, Shelby. Did you listen to me?
I know all about adoption, Mama. And I would never do anything stupid. I know all about the limitations of this body of mine.
Well, finally you're listening to reason.
Shelby, you're gonna have to start untangling this baby's breath.
Shelby, no!
It's what? My wedding. I'll stick baby's breath up my nose if I want to.
Fine.
She's got enough of it.
I mean, I'm supposed to be the expert in behavior, and I can't seem to manage the people in my own family.
Oh, did you tell him, Mama?
Tell us what?
Nothing. I just might be promoted to administrator at the Mental Guidance Center.
Oh, wonderful. That guidance center does such good work for the disturbed.
I wish I'd taken my boys there when they were younger and straightened them out. I should have known Louie had problems when his imaginary playmates wouldn't play with him.
Your boys grew up fine. They're just a little scary, that's all.
I just think it must be fun to have access to all that personal information. Malin, tell us about some of your most bizarre mental cases, and let us guess who they are. There's some real sick tickets in this town.
I will not discuss office business in a social setting. People need a place where they can come and unload their personal problems. I'll never violate their confidence.
When Mom says she doesn't talk, she means it. She's a brick wall.
Well, you know what somebody always says, if you don't have anything nice to say about anybody, come sit by me.
You know, we're being really rude to poor Annette here.
Annelle.
Annelle,
She doesn't know us from Adam's house cat. Here we are going on about things that are foreign to her experiences. Annette, tell us about yourself.
There's nothing to tell.
Well, where do you live?
On the corner of Jefferson and 2nd.
Which corner?
The one where you can't see the house for the weeds.
You must live at Miss Robeline's house.
She's my landlady.
Are you getting along with her?
What's the matter with her?
Nothing. Are you happy there?
She scares me. She's always watching me. Sometimes I catch her looking through my keyhole.
She must not be taking her medication. I'll check on her on Monday. Shelby, why don't you finish that juice?
I'm fine, Mama. You finish it.
It's going to be a while before the bridesmaids' luncheon. Why don't you finish it?
You know what you need in here, Truvy? A radio. Music is wonderful to have in the background. It takes the pressure off to having to talk so much. Well, I used to have one, but I smashed it against the wall when I couldn't figure out where the batteries went. I now know I was a victim of premenstrual syndrome. I've gotten 4 radios for wedding presents. I'll give you one.
That's sweet. What did I just hear? Oh, yes, the Antilli family is selling KPPD. I wonder how much radio stations sell for.
A lot. But you know, a small town radio station could be a license to print money if it's run right.
You should buy KPPD. You got plenty of money.
What would I do with a radio station? Business never interested me at all. Lloyd took care of all that stuff.
Shelby, finish the juice.
Forget the damn juice.
Shelby will be fine now. Besides, I always carry extra candy in my purse.
Ooh, get away the butterscotches in that dish over there. Clairee, throw one in a bag. They are the best. They start out real hard, but after you suck all the coating off, they get real chewy. My 2 favorite things, crunchy, chewy, and buttery. Oh, they are so good.
Malin?
Mm-hmm?
Do you always carry candy in your bag?
Without fail.
Well, tell me, do you suck on this all?
Clairee, put that back.
I hate it when people bring weapons into my shop.
How did you get Daddy's gun away from him? I've been waiting all morning for my opportunity. He finally put it down to go to the bathroom.
Can I ask a question? I'm new here and all. Is my life in danger?
No. Malin's husband's just been shooting at some birds. The trees are full of them this time of year.
See, all our backyard is full of all of these fruit trees.
Which are full of birds.
Full of birds.
Daddy's been making loud noises trying to scare the birds out the trees. We didn't want the guests at my reception spending all night dodging bird dew.
The neighborhood is fit to be tied. Ouiser Boudreau blames my husband's gunshots for the problems with that mangy dog of hers. She insists that all the noise has been making that stupid animal lose all its hair.
Malin, taking that gun was a stroke of genius.
Yeah, I know.
But what if he comes over here and tries to get his gun back?
Trum would never step foot in a beauty parlor. This is women's territory. He probably thinks we all run around naked or something.
There's somebody coming. A strange lady with a strange dog.
That would be Ouiser.
That is one ugly dog. What kind of dog is that?
If Rhett had hair, he'd be a collie.
Lord, give us strength.
This is it. I found it. Ouiser. I'm in hell.
You're a little early. We weren't expecting you till about 11-ish.
That's precisely why I'm here. I have to take my poor dog to the vet before he has a nervous breakdown. The dog, that is. The vet is perfectly healthy. You must be the new girl.
Hi.
May I have a glass of water? I've been screaming this morning.
Please, this whole thing has gotten completely out of hand. I'm sorry.
It's not your fault, Malin. I used to think that you were crazy for marrying that man. Then I thought for a few years you were just a glutton for punishment. Now I know that you must be on some mission from God. I have not slept in days. I look like a dog's dinner. However, when I got up this morning, I decided I would try to rise above it. I would start anew. Whatever that man has done, I would overlook it in honor of your wedding day, Shelby. I decided I would make myself a little presentable and floss up the house in case somebody were to drop in, it being a big day in the neighborhood and all. So I go out to cut some fresh flowers for the living room. I go down to my magnolia tree, and there is not a bloom on it.
Ouiser, the judge has not decided whose tree that is exactly.
It's mine. Be that as it may, it would not be too much to ask for me to have even one blossom to brighten my home. I'm all alone except for my dog.
You need something in your life besides that dumb animal.
Put a lid on it, Clairee. I was standing there looking at my naked magnolia tree when I saw Drum across the way, loading what appeared to be a cannon. I asked him what happened to all those blossoms. He said the wind must have blown them off in the night. Then I asked him how the wind managed to blow them all off into your pool. Then he fired at me. Is that rude or what?
To the blanks. And Drum would never aim a gun at a lady.
Oh, he's a real gentleman. I'll bet he takes the dishes out of the sink before he pees in it.
That was uncalled for.
All I know is my poor dog has got to be sedated. He has a condition.
Are you sure that's true? Rit is a very old dog.
I'm simply going on what the vet tells me.
Which vet?
Whitey Black.
Well, that's your first mistake. Whitey Black is a moron. I'm not even sure he has opposable thumbs.
Miss Ouiser, Daddy's not trying to drive you crazy. He just wants to make my reception nice. His heart's in the right place.
But he cannot do this to my dog. My dog is on his last legs. What am I going to do with the poor animal?
I got a lot of good recipes here.
Darling, whatever your name is, would you look out the window and check on my dog while I smack Clairee in her smart mouth? You may not believe this, but these are the dearest friends I have in this town.
His color's good. His skin is real pink.
Miss Ouiser, I know for a fact there'll be no more gunshots. So why don't you relax? Have some coffee. Ladies, this is going to work out beautifully. I'm almost done with Shelby, and Annelle can shampoo Ouiser. See? Life can be wonderful.
All right. As long as there are no more gunshots, I'll stay. What is your name? Did you tell me?
Annelle.
Fine. Are you new in this town? I don't recall ever seeing you before, and I know everyone.
I just moved here not too long ago.
With your family?
No, ma'am. I don't have any family to speak of.
With your husband?
My husband. That's hard to say. I don't know.
You don't know?
I'm not sure.
I'm intrigued. Are you married or are you not? These are not difficult questions.
We're not. He's not. I can't talk about it.
Of course you can!
I don't know if I'm married or not. He's gone.
Oh, honey, men are horrible creatures. Horrible.
Everything is horrible. Funky, that's my husband. He left. We just moved here a month ago. He just vanished last week.
No idea where he went?
Nobody knows. He took the money, my jewelry, the car. Most of my clothes were in the trunk.
But it may have been foul play. Have you been in touch with the police?
No, but they've been to me. He's in big trouble with the law. Drugs or something. He never paid the rent, so I got thrown out of our house and had to move in at crazy old Mrs. Robelene's. The police keep questioning me, but I don't know anything. They say my marriage may not be legal.
You should have said something.
I was scared to. I need a job in the worst way, and I didn't know if you'd hire someone who may or may not be married to someone who might be a dangerous criminal. But I swear to you that my personal tragedy will not interfere with my ability to do good hair.
Of course it won't.
I really don't think things could get any worse.
Of course they can.
You are so brave. You must be made of courage.
I'm totally alone. Checks are bouncing everywhere. Everything is going wrong. I keep asking myself, why me?
We are awful. We are all hateful, awful people. Here, all we've been talking about is weddings and psychotic animals. We've been tearing you up inside. I can't tell you how sorry I am. You've had such a terrible time. Sometimes we don't know how lucky we are.
What can we do to help?
I know one thing we can do. Tonight, you're gonna drop by my house and have some bleeding armadillo's groom's cake. It's gonna be a great party.
I couldn't. I still get real emotional sometimes.
Oh, but I can't stand the thought of someone being alone or unhappy tonight. And if you feel yourself starting to get sad, just watch my husband dance. It's very funny.
It is. You all are so nice.
Well, we enjoy being nice to one another. There's not much else to do in this town.
But I don't have anything to wear.
I bet I'll have something that'll do. I'll call the house.
Annelle, my garage apartment is going to be available soon. My son is living there now, but give me a day or two to clean it up and sweep up the bed and then come take a look. I'm sure we can work on something on the rent.
Oh, good. Jonathan, you have to do me a favor. Yes, now. Go in my closet and get two or three of my Sunday things. Just anything. Use your judgment. Very well. Bring me the pink dress with the white collar, the pink suit jacket with the cherries pinned on it, and the pink and white polka dot. No, Jonathan, Mama doesn't have Daddy's gun. Well, don't you have better things to do? What? We'll stop him! Now!
Something the matter?
We'll see.
Yes!
Oh my, what happened?
Daddy tied explosives to Jonathan's G.I. Joe bow and arrow and shot it into the tree.
What in the hell?
Shut up, Brick!
She wrote, I'm gonna let that man have it.
Oh no! Your dog broke his chain and he's headed toward the smoke.
Oh no, that dog will eat Drum alive. And Drum is unarmed.
Ouiser, do something. Ouiser, call your dog.
He'll listen to you.
Miss Ouiser, please, it's my wedding day. Say something to your dog.
Kill, Rick, kill!
Shelby!
Mama! Where is everybody?
I thought you weren't coming in until after lunch.
We
We got Nellie stopped because of traffic. We wanted to drop in on Jackson's parents on the way down here.
What a treat.
And you have to catch them early. On Saturdays, they leave the house at the crack of dawn to start hunting furry little creatures.
Well, you must not have stayed long.
We didn't. I could tell they were getting anxious to stop killing things. We stopped by the house first. Nobody was there. Where's Truvy?
Oh, she and Annelle are out back sticking pennies in the fuse box. They decorated that little tree over there, and when I went to plug it in, all the lights blew.
What are those things?
Oh, these are red plastic poinsettia earrings. They're a gift from Annelle. She's discovered the wonderful world of arts and crafts.
Oh. Are Tommy and Jonathan home yet?
Yes. Jonathan got in last evening. Yesterday morning. And he loves his classes. That's all we can talk about. I think the one thing that architecture school has taught him is how much he has to hate his mother's house. Tommy got in last night and immediately started terrorizing your father. So nice having the family home for Christmas.
Some things never change.
Well, how are you?
I'm so good, Mama, just great.
Well, you're looking well. Is Jackson at the house?
Oh, no. You know how twitchy he gets. I sent him to look for some stocking stuffers.
Good thinking.
Jackson and I have something to tell you. We wanted to tell you when you and Daddy were together. But you're never together, so every man for himself. I'm pregnant.
Shelby,
I'm going to have a baby.
Well, I realize that.
Is that it? Is that all you're going to say?
What do you want me to say?
Something along the lines of congratulations.
Congratulations.
Would it be too much to ask for a little bit of excitement? Not too much. I wouldn't want you to break a sweat or anything.
I'm in shock. I mean, I didn't think that you could...
In June. Oh, Mama, you have to help me plan. We're going to get a new house. Jackson loves hunting for anything. We're going house hunting this weekend.
What does Jackson say about all this?
Oh, he's very excited. He says he couldn't care whether it's a boy or a girl. But I know he really wants a son so bad he can taste it. He's so cute about the whole thing. It's all he talks about. Jackson Lattery Jr.
But does he ever listen? When the doctors and specialists give you advice. I know you never do, but does he? I know. I guess since he doesn't have to carry the baby, it doesn't really concern him.
Mama, please don't be mad. I couldn't bear it if you were. It's Christmas.
I'm not mad, Shelby. This is just hard. I don't know.
Mama, I want a child.
What about adoption? I mean, you filed so many applications.
Mama, it didn't take us long to see the handwriting on the walls. No judge is going to give a baby to someone with my medical track record. Jackson even put out feelers about buying one.
People do it all the time.
I want a child of my own. I think it would help things a lot.
Oh, I see.
I know, Mama. I know. Don't think I haven't thought this through. I know you're worried, but I never worry because I know you're worried enough for the both of us. Jackson and I have given this a lot of thought.
Has he really? Well, there's a first time for everything.
Don't start on Jackson.
Shelby, your poor body has been through so much. Why would you deliberately want to do this?
Diabetics have held the babies all the time.
But you are special, Shelby. There are limits to what you can do.
Mama, listen. I have it all planned. I'm going to be very careful. And by this time next year, I'm going to bring your big, healthy grandbaby to the Christmas festival. No one is going to be hurt or disappointed or even inconvenienced.
Least of all Jackson, I'm sure.
You are jealous because you no longer have a say-so in what I do, and that drives you up a wall. You're ready to spit nails because you can't call the shots.
I did not raise my daughter to talk to me this way.
Yes, you did. Whenever any of us asked what we wanted to be when we grew up, what did you say?
Shelby, I am not in the mood to play games.
What did you say? Just tell me what you said. Answer me.
The only thing I ever said is that I wanted you to be happy. Sit.
Okay. The thing that would make me happy is to have a baby. If I could adopt one, I would. But I can't. I'm going to have a baby. And I wish you would be happy for me, too.
Well, you know what I wish? Oh, I don't know what I wish.
Mama, I don't know why you have to make everything so difficult. I look at having this baby as an opportunity of a lifetime. Sure, there may be some risks involved. That's true for anybody.
But you get through life, and life goes on. And when it's all said and done, there'll be a little piece of immortality with Jackson's good looks and my sense of style, I hope. Oh, Mama, please, I need your support. I would rather have 30 minutes of wonderful than a lifetime of nothing special.
They're on, Truvy.
Mama, please don't say anything yet. I want to tell Daddy first.
I never tell anybody anything.
Well, look who's here. Come give me a hug right here and now.
Truvy, Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho. And now we have a special mystery visitor. You have the honor of lighting the tree of beauty.
Oh. What a novel idea to trim it with hair things.
It was all Annelle. She has quite an eye for the unusual.
Hi there. Annelle, you did all this.
Guilty. Truvy just turned over the decoration responsibilities to me. I like themes, and I despise the commercialization of Christmas. So, I went to the fire sale at the Baptist bookstore in Shreveport last month. They had mismatched manger scenes at incredibly low prices. I cleaned them out of baby Jesus's, which Truvy's husband helped me modify into ornaments. Very simple. Tiny white lights, baby Jesus's, and spoolies.
My husband turned Poots' old room into a little workshop, so Annelle could have a place to work on her handicrafts.
Isn't that nice? Are your boys coming home for Christmas?
No. Louis brought his girlfriend home for Thanksgiving, and the nicest thing I can say about her is all her tattoos were spelled correctly. So, I guess it's just me, the old man, and Annelle. Do the honors, Missy, and make sure it doesn't blow up in the process.
Okay.
Here we go.
Oh! See, I know what I'm doing.
You do. I know your mom was so happy that you could get in early for the festival. See the festival? It's going to be the best one ever. There's going to be more fireworks, a nativity built entirely out of sparklers, and a big new sign on the riverbank that says, I heart Shanklepin Parish. It is going to be spectacular. And guess who the Grand Marshal of the Parade is? Wayne Newton.
Oh, I wouldn't miss the Christmas festival for the world. Oh, Mama, while I'm thinking, I bought some white chocolate cherry cheesecakes for the open house tonight.
That doesn't sound like finger food to me.
They're bite-sized, like this.
Fine, I'm sure you know what you're doing.
Annelle?
Perfect.
Oh, and Mama, I've been going through my closets, getting rid of stuff. I brought you some things that I've hardly worn. I thought maybe your patients might be less disturbed if they had something stylish to wear.
Annelle?
The couch. Excuse me, Shelby? If you don't have any special plans for the clothes, can I have them? Riverview Baptist has a clothes closet for the poor. We're real low on women's dresses.
Sure, what a wonderful idea. They're in the car. I'll get them in a minute.
It just breaks my heart that she won't go to the Methodist church with me. I feel that Riverview Baptist is a little too praise the Lord for my taste.
Some of them do get a little carried away, but there's nothing wrong with that.
No, a lot of Mama's mental patients are born-again Christians. I mean that in the best sense of the word.
We're just glad Annelle is settling down and finding her way. She had a few rough months there, didn't you?
Oh, after they finally threw Bunky Dupree behind bars and I was rid of him, I went wild. I was drinking, running around, smoking.
Jezebel!
Truvy helped me see the error of my ways. I realized I have something to offer. I joined a church last month. Truvy helped me see I have talents. I've done guest lectures on beauty at the trade school.
Our little Annelle has become one of the hottest chickens in town.
Truvy, stop. I am enjoying the city more, and I am so excited about the Christmas festival today. Wanted to come to it all my life, and now I live here.
Well, tell her who you have a date with.
Truvy, hush.
Come on, tell her, Missy. Shelby's pretty much totally responsible for the whole thing.
Sammy DeSoto.
Oh, he has a body that doesn't stop anywhere.
How am I responsible?
He was bartending at your wedding reception last spring. That's when I met him. He makes the mean cherry coke.
Romance.
It's what I live for. Shelby, can we do anything for you?
Oh, I'm beyond help. Last week, I discovered the early stages of crow's feet.
Well, time marches on, and eventually you discover it's marching across your face. How you doing, honey?
Never better.
My annual pecan tassies.
There she is. You must be the happy one this morning.
Yes, I am. First state championship in 8 years.
Miss Clairee, you sound awful.
Hello, darling.
Can I get you some tea?
Yes, that would be nice. I'm sorry I'm late. I overslept. We didn't get back into town until 1 o'clock. It was a dazzling victory over dry prom.
I heard you on the radio last night. You were wonderful.
What were you doing on the radio?
They let me be the color announcer for the Devils. I was fabulous. Too colorful for words.
Well, that was awfully nice of them to let you talk on the radio.
Nice nothing. I own the radio station.
You bought it?
Yes. KPPD, the station of choice in Chicopin Parish.
And how do you like the new short and sassy look?
I love it.
Well, just wait till I jack it up.
It makes you look younger, Miss Clairee.
My hair looks younger. My face looks just as old.
There's so much going on. The state championship last night, the Christmas festival today, the Messiah sing-along tomorrow.
Life in a big city will spoil you.
Who's Miss Merry Christmas this year?
My niece, Nancy Beth, of course.
She was here at 7 o'clock this morning. I had to position her tiara properly on her head so it wouldn't slip off during the parade. I sprayed her hair within an inch of its life.
I should have known. All you Marmillions are gorgeous. Beauty is genetic in your family.
Nancy Beth is a pretty girl. Do you know she's Miss Merry Christmas, Miss Soybean, and Miss Watermelon?
But dumb as a post.
Empty as the head that wears the crown.
I do feel like God did a little dance around that family. Drew is so successful, and Belle does her own hair. And those children are perfect. They're like a family on TV. They don't have a care in the world.
That's not necessarily true.
Oh?
That's all I'm saying. Well, I should have won Miss Merry Christmas the year I ran. My talent was very showy.
We told you at the time, Shelby, fire batons are not everyone's cup of tea.
Mama didn't approve of those fire batons. I just don't approve when you insist on doing dangerous things.
Mama hated those fire batons.
I've never hated anything, Shelby. I supported you, just couldn't watch you. Your father, on the other hand, he had a field day. He used to get so much pleasure out of standing in the backyard for hours, watching you practice, holding the garden hose so he could put you out when you caught fire.
My entire pageant ensemble was coordinated in shades of pink, soup to nuts. I twirled to the music from Hawaii 5-0. It was my theme song.
We were proud of her.
Well, the year I competed, the swimsuit competition was my downfall. Most women look for a swimsuit that will lift and separate. I look for one that will divide and conquer. I've always been built for comfort, not for speed.
And who won the title your year, Miss Clairee?
Oh, child, nobody. There wasn't even a Christmas festival when I was in high school. Why, Jesus wasn't even born until I was a junior in college. I remember it distinctly. My friends and I were all out watching our flocks by night.
Clairee, get over there. Annelle's got a gift wrap your head.
I could just spit.
Morning, Ouiser.
The parade doesn't even start for 4 hours, and already people are parking on my lawn. It's gonna flatten my grass.
Here, let me hold you.
I hate out-of-town tours.
Hello.
Oh, what are you doing here, Shelby?
Being a tourist, I guess. But I promise I won't flatten your grass.
You had the good sense to move away from this festival madness. I can't understand why you would drag yourself back here for a couple of firecrackers and some drunk teenagers irping on your shoes.
I like it.
Miss Ouiser, I think you need a healthy dose of Christmas spirit.
I have so much Christmas spirit I could scream.
Merry Christmas.
I just finished putting out my yard decorations.
Ouiser, keep off the grass signs are not Christmas decorations.
They are bordered in holly. Oh, you made these, didn't you?
With my own two hands.
Your present's back at the house. I still have to wrap it.
How's Red?
He's getting along. As a matter of fact, he's the poster dog for the Christmas festival.
That is Red? I would never have recognized him.
It's nice to see Rhett with some hair again.
Well, I have some errands to run. But Miss Ouiser, before I go, I've met an old friend of yours.
Oh?
Owen Jenkins?
Owen? Now there's a blast from the past.
Do you remember him? Because he remembers you.
Of course I remember him. He has the longest nose hair in the free world.
Well, he hardly has any hair anywhere now.
Owen's been gone from Chinkapin since God was a boy. I'd forgotten he'd ever existed.
Well, now, he lives in Monroe and goes to First Presbyterian. He sings in the choir there. Last week at choir practice, we were doing an especially beautiful Mozart thing. It moved me to tears. He offered me his handkerchief. We got to talking, and he asked me where I was from. When he found out, he asked me if I knew you. I said, not only do I know you, but you are my neighbor, and your father has almost killed your dog has almost killed my father on numerous occasions. He had a very interesting life. He lived in Ohio somewhere. His wife just died recently.
Does this story have a point?
Just that he remembers you fondly, I think.
Well, I can't imagine why. He wasn't a bad fella, but I managed to run him off and marry the first of two total deadbeats.
Unrequited love, my favorite.
Maybe sometime I could arrange for us to get together.
Maybe not.
Now,
Shelby, listen, I managed in just a few decades to marry the two most worthless men in the universe and then proceed to have the three most ungrateful children ever conceived. The only reason people are nice to me is because I have more money than God. I'm not about to open a new can of worms.
Do I detect a negativity in your tone?
Ouiser, if that's really how you feel, it isn't healthy. Maybe you should think about coming on down to the guidance center and talking to someone. You know, with that help.
I am not crazy. I've just been in a very bad mood for 40 years.
Well, now, what do you want me to do with those old clothes? I gotta get them out of the back seat.
Just bring them in.
Okay. And then I'll finish my Christmas shopping, Mama.
I could just shoot you. I haven't even started yet.
Please, I haven't even washed the dishes from Thanksgiving.
What did you get your Mama?
I told her what part of it was this morning.
Well, tell us, Missy. Come on.
I think it's a secret.
There's no such thing in this room.
It's up to you, honey.
I'm going to have a baby!
Oh, Grahn, congratulations!
Wow.
Malin?
Grandma? No wonder you haven't said much today. Aren't you excited?
Smile. It increases your face value.
June 21.
And the doctor said you couldn't have children. What did they know? You showed them.
The doctor said she shouldn't have children. There's a very big difference. I guess you showed us all, Shelby.
I've got to get the clothes. Miss Ouiser, are you bringing your shrimp mince pie to our open house tonight?
Don't I always? They'll be there.
Good. So will Owen Jenkins. I open the worms for you.
I can't believe that girl. Owen, after all these years, I don't think I can be gracious under pressure.
Shelby, you know, her heart does get the best of her sometimes.
This baby, it's not necessarily the best news, is it, Malin?
I mean, she wants it so badly, but I just don't know.
Boy. Well, I wish I had some words of wisdom, but I don't. So I'm going to focus on the joy of the occasion. Congratulations.
Absolutely.
Diabetics have healthy babies all the time.
They do.
It will all be fine.
Of course it will.
You're right, ladies. We'll get through this just fine. And like they say, that which doesn't kill us makes us stronger.
What's that girl up to?
Shelby's donating some clothes to the poor.
I hope poor people like pink.
Just throw them on the couch.
Miss Malin, are you sure you don't mind me taking them? If your patients need them.
Shelby said you can have them, and what Shelby says goes.
That's not true, Mama.
Shelby, you always insist on having the last word.
I do not!
We're going to take a short intermission. There'll be concessions out in the courtyard area if you'd like to take part in the refreshments. We'll be back in about 15 minutes, so go ahead and take your breaks. Bathrooms are straight down the hall this way. The exit out to the courtyard, go down the stairs to your left. There's a door out into the courtyard.
Thank you.
see how good looking I really am. Coming up now, I have 5 non-stop music so I can make it up to the shopping center. Let's hope none of these records has a scratch on them, because I'm out of here. I'm going to kick things off with one of my personal all-time favorites. See you at the shopping center.
But didn't he scare you to death by coming by so late?
It wasn't that late. About 9:30, I guess.
Still, somebody knocking on my bedroom window after dark would scare the daylights out of me.
Not me. Hope springs eternal, I suppose. I was so disappointed when I realized it was only my nephew.
Well, I just think it's awful of Drew to throw his son out the house. Parents should never throw their children out the house.
Well, my brother can be very hot-headed when he wants to be, but he really didn't throw Marshall out. Marshall just came over to my house while his daddy cooled off. I adore Marshall. We stayed up half the night talking last night.
Well, there we are. Are you ready to see the new Shelby lechery?
I don't know.
Come on, you have to look sometime. Our world is full of reflective surfaces.
Oh, I can't believe I'm getting so worked up over something as silly as a haircut.
You look precious.
Okay. I'm ready.
Oh, gosh! It's so weird!
Oh, I did what you wanted, didn't I?
Oh, yes, it's just, I've never had shorter hair, that's all.
This is what us Cosmo girls call a rite of passage.
I can't believe I'm being so ridiculous. I'm sorry.
Honey, please don't cry, because you know I will too. And I have a strict philosophy that no one cries alone in my presence.
Ladies, please.
Remind me never to take these two to see dark victory. They'd never survive.
Oh, come on. Enough. I love my hair.
Oh, I'm so relieved. My artistic nature is so relieved.
It's very becoming. I guess with that baby, you don't have time to spend hours fussing with your hair. You need something you could just run your fingers through and go.
It's totally adorable. Your mom's gonna love it.
Mama's gonna freak out. She just thinks I'm getting a trim. I wasn't up for a big debate this morning. Now, Truvy, let's do my nails.
What a surprise! No one around here ever wants a full manicure. I don't even know what to charge for a full day of beauty.
I want the works. I want to be completely pampered today. Mama's gonna want a manicure, too.
Well, I'm going to need to paint my front door red and change my name to Elizabeth Arden.
Manicures and saucy new hairdos. What's going on?
Oh, we're always up to something. You know that. But I want to get back to this Drew and Belle nonsense. I hope they reconcile with Marshall. Speaking as a parent, they better get their act together. I do not approve of friction between parents and children.
I think it'll all blow over. I have to admit, he did go about it the wrong way.
What did he do?
He marched in unexpected from Los Angeles while Drew and Belle were preparing for their annual Marmillion shrimp boil. Marshall, without so much as a hello, says, Mama and Daddy, I have something to tell you. I have a brain tumor. I have 3 months to live. Well, naturally, Drew and Belle became hysterical. Then he said, hey, folks, I'm just kidding. I'm only gay.
Oh, my goodness. That was his idea of breaking the news gently?
Well, Drew became incredibly distraught and started throwing wet shrimp at him, screaming at him to get out of his sight. So Marshall came over to my house, smelling like a can of cat food.
Well, how do you think Drew and Belle are feeling right now?
I don't know. They just considered themselves to be a model family for so long. First with Nancy Beth dethroned from her Miss Merry Christmas title after that unfortunate motel thing.
What motel thing? I don't live around here anymore, remember?
Well, Nancy Beth was caught in a nearby hotel with a high political official. They were both high. They'd been smoking everything but their shoes.
Oh. To be the only Miss Merry Christmas in history caught with her tinsel down around her knees was a very humiliating experience for the Marmillion family. Oh. How do you feel about Marshall?
I haven't really thought about it, but I want you to know he's always welcome at my house. I'm very proud of him. He built up that chain of sportswear stores all by himself without a penny of family money. He says, I'm a self-made man. I pulled myself up by my own jock straps.
Annelle.
Oh. Amen.
Amen. Annelle, we're out of this.
Is it still next to?
It's over there.
Okay.
Was she praying?
Yep. Why? Well, I don't know. She could have been praying for Drew and Belle and Marshall. She could have been praying because we were gossiping. She could have been praying because the elastic on her pantyhose is shot. Who knows? She prays at the drop of a hat these days.
How long has she been this way?
Well, ever since Mardi Gras. She had the choice of going to a Bible weekend with her Sunday school class or to Mardi Gras to New Orleans with me and a couple other sinners. Well, she left that Friday, a properly adjusted, lovely young lady, and returned on Tuesday, a Christian.
And what does her boyfriend say?
Sammy doesn't know whether to scratch his watch or wind his butt. He's crazy about her. He says he could deal with another man in her life, but he doesn't know what to do about the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Well, I'm pretty religious, but that stuff makes me feel kind of creepy.
I don't know what to think. On the one hand, I have two sons I feel are going to hell in a handcart, and a daughter that tries to be the kind of girl that Jesus would bring home to Mama. I don't know. Those people, I don't know. Sometimes they have a peace about them that I don't have. Maybe I'm just jealous.
Oh, and Marshall is so thoughtful. He brought me this pin. It's golden enamel.
It's a bug.
It's fine jewelry. Its little eyes are rubies in my birthstone.
Does Marshall have friends?
Well, we talked a little bit about that. I'm such a nosy old thing. I asked him how he met people. Because in my day, you could tell by a man's carriage and demeanor which side his bread was buttered on. But today, in this day and age, who knows? I asked Marshall, how can you tell? And he said, all gay men have track lighting. And all gay men are named Mark, Rick, or Steve.
He's such a nut.
Track lighting?
Track lighting?
Morning.
Good morning, Lisa.
What's so funny?
Miss Clairee was just telling us the true story of track lighting.
I love mine. It highlights my new artwork.
Since when do you have track lighting?
About 3 weeks. It's in my foyer and up the stairs. It was my grandson's idea.
How is he? I haven't seen him in ages.
Steve's fine. I brought you all some tomatoes, first of the season. I didn't expect to see you in town, Shelby.
Well, I'm here.
Well, take some tomatoes back home with you. There's plenty. Boy, they're short. Looks good.
Thank you, Miss Ouiser. Jack Jr. loves tomatoes. He smears them on the cafe curtains in the kitchen.
Your mama was telling us you'd become quite the gourmet cook.
Oh, when I first married, all Jackson wanted was meat, potatoes, and vegetables. Cooked to mush, just the way his mama made them. But I broke him of that. Last week, I even got some pate down him. He swore it was dog food. But Jack Jr. loved it, though.
Clairee, how many tomatoes do you want? Tomatoes have no calories, and they're full of things.
Ouiser, you're almost chipper today. Why are you in such a good mood? Did you run over a small child or something?
Do you or do you not want tomatoes?
Well, don't give me all of them.
Well, somebody's got to take them. I hate them. I try not to eat healthy food if I can help it. The sooner this body wears out, the better off I'll be. I've trouble getting enough grease in my diet.
Then why do you grow them?
Because I'm an old southern woman. We're supposed to put on funny-looking hats and ugly old dresses and grow vegetables in the dirt. Don't ask me why. I don't make the rules.
You need to get yourself some gloves. Your hands look like a couple of T-bone steaks.
Health is the most important thing, Miss Ouiser. Trust me on this.
While I have everyone's attention, I went out to my mailbox this morning and discovered that someone has put me on the mailing list for the Riverview Baptist Church. Lucky me, I'm now receiving chain letters for Christ.
They aren't chain letters. They're part of my prayer group's Reach Out and Touch project. We were each supposed to write somebody in the community that we thought might be in spiritual trouble and invite them to worship. I guess you made everybody's list.
I think it is in the worst possible taste to pray for perfect strangers.
Reach out to Ouiser and you'll pull back a bloody stump. Shelby, I just realized you saved me a phone call. Next Friday, Sis, Aurel, and I are coming up to Monroe, and we'd like to take you and Jackson to dinner, if we may.
I can't Friday night. I'm sorry. What's the occasion?
Well, this is going to sound a little silly, but we're coming up to go to the Little Theater. We have tickets to a play.
I didn't think you went to see anything without a goalpost at either end.
Well, up until now, I haven't. But Sis and I decided at Bridge one day that we needed to keep up. We wanted to expose ourselves to a little more culture. That is not easy to come by in this neck of the woods.
Well, what exactly exposing yourself to?
I don't know. Something. The last thing we saw there was pretty good. It was Shakespeare. I was a little apprehensive at first, but you know what? When you get right down to it, he writes pretty straightforward stuff. I have to admit, when they hide behind curtains and put those little masks over their faces to fool people, that gets kind of silly. Sis fell for it, but I didn't.
Sis Orell is so dumb, she thinks Sherlock Holmes is a subdivision.
Anyway, Sis and I like it so much, we're planning a theater trip to New York.
New York? Clairee, I am green with envy. You have to go to Bloomingdale's and tell me all about it. Woman C says if you walk to the first floor, you can't help but get made of.
Well, we're just talking. I'm scared to death of getting on a plane.
Oh, it's a piece of cake. It's much safer than being in a car. Just sit in the back. That's the safest place to avoid the crash.
Miss Ouiser, why don't you go to Monroe with Miss Clairee?
I'm not exposing myself to anything.
You should broaden your horizons.
You broaden your horizons your way, I'll broaden my horizons mine. Besides, I have plans next Friday. I'm going to Shreveport to get my colors done.
Your what?
I'm going to get my colors done. I'm going to find out if I'm a summer or spring or fall or winter. It was a present from Owen.
What are you talking about?
Everybody has a particular coloring. You determine what season you are, summer, spring, so on. Then you know what colors look best on you. Then you're given samples of your colors that are in your special palette. It's most helpful when you go shopping. It gives you fashion courage.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard of.
Well, it's all the rage.
A lot of my friends in Monroe have had it done. There's a quiz right over there in that family circle on that very topic. I am the epitome of winter.
Shelby, why don't you have it done? You're so fashion conscious.
Oh no, I'm afraid to. I might find out that pink is not in my palette, and I'm not sure I could live with that.
Well, I've heard it all. Well, I'm going to the theater. I'm going to support the arts in our area.
I will write a check. I will support art. I just don't want to see it.
It wouldn't tear-lip you, you know.
Let's get one thing straight. I don't see plays because I could nap at home for free. I don't see movies because they're all full of naked people and trashy. And I don't read books because if they're any good, they'll be made into a miniseries.
I'm surprised you and Daddy don't get along any better than you do. Oh, Miss Ouiser, how are things with Owen? I try to check in on you, but I haven't been able to lately.
They're all right. I enjoy his company on occasion.
I can report that the Sherwood florist delivery truck stops by her house at least twice a week.
He knows I like fresh flowers.
And I can report there's a strange car parked in her garage at least once a week.
Oh, yeah, my secret's out. I'm having an affair with a Mercedes Benz.
Ouiser, forgive me, but I've been dying to ask this. Are you and Owen?
Well, you know.
Wait. I have to get a mental picture of this.
A dirty mind is a terrible thing to waste. But no, we are friends. He would like more. I'm dealing with that, but I'm old and set in my ways.
You are playing hard to get. At her age, she should be playing beat the clock. She's just like her old dog. Both have trouble with their new tricks.
No talking trash in my shop.
I can't help it if men find me desirable, Clairee.
Shelby, when are you going to bring that baby of yours by?
Oh, I brought a picture of him.
Has he gained any weight?
He's about 15 pounds now.
God, he's a tiny thing.
He only weighed a pound and a half when he was born, but he'll catch up. Give him time.
Bless his heart. Well, those were some anxious hours, weren't they? We didn't know who to worry about the most, you or that baby.
Well, I certainly wouldn't recommend having a baby 3 months premature.
I get upset thinking about it.
Then let's don't. Yep, Jack Jr., he's a little fighter, and he's gonna wear me out.
I wish I knew where he gets all that energy from.
Well, don't do it all yourself. You get your husband to help you out. They're supposed to be helping out in this decade.
He helps, I guess. Mama doesn't think he does. But he does. Sometimes. When he thinks about it. Which isn't often. Most of the time he doesn't do a damn thing. And every weekend he's off hunting.
Well, Jackson's a good provider, isn't he?
That's true.
Well,
He'll come around, and when he does, you run and tell me how you did it, and I'll work on that sofa slug that I'm married to.
This one's pretty.
Oh, Private Passion. My favorite.
It's luscious without being sleazy. Now, ladies, we're going to have to make some time adjustments next Saturday. Annelle is taking a well-deserved vacation.
Oh, that's nice.
Are you taking a trip?
Yes, I am.
Aren't you going to tell us where you're going?
Nope.
Please, Annelle, I don't know how I'll get through the week without this information.
You'll just make fun.
Annelle, you know I love it when you go on and on about your spiritual growth.
Annelle has a nice little trip planned to Camp Crossroads in the Ozarks.
I don't think I know a Camp Crossroads.
It's in the middle of Arkansas. It's a Christian camp. There's just a chapel, cabins, and a dining hall in the middle of the mountains with a lake. I will spend a week in Bible study, prayer, and meditation. You're in the middle of nature, surrounded by the beauty of the Lord.
Are there waterbeds?
Ouiser, leave her alone.
I'm just trying to find out more about Camp Cross-Eyed. I might want to go.
That's a laugh. You had never done a religious thing in your life.
That is not true. When I was in school, my friends and I would dress up like nuns and go bar hopping.
Is your boyfriend going with you?
No. He said he'd rather eat dirt.
You know, I'm going to check up on my granddaughter and make sure she's still going to the Episcopal Church. This born-again process feels awfully tedious.
I have to say this to you, Miss Ouiser, and I don't mean to hurt you, but I worry about your faith sometimes.
My faith is just fine. It's my hair that needs the most work.
Ouiser, one of these days somebody's going to cut the feet out of your stockings.
Ouiser, have you no shame?
It's okay, Truvy. I love Miss Ouiser. I pray for her every day. Sometimes twice.
Morning, everybody.
Shelby!
Mama, please don't say anything. I like it. It'll be so much easier to deal with.
Oh, honey, bless your heart.
It'll dry so quick, you just run your fingers through it.
You know, the last time you had short hair, I think, was kindergarten.
I know. I decided today that I'm going to get my hair all cut off every 25 years.
Well, I love it. I do.
It's not too perky, is it?
No, looks good. How you doing, honey?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. Brought you a goodie. You can open it later.
Melinda, it must be nice having your entire family home this weekend.
It's rare indeed, but it's been nice.
What's the occasion?
Oh, just to get together. Last week was Drum and I's anniversary.
Well, why didn't you say something to remind me? I would have baked you something. Drum loves my nut surprise cake.
Well, we've never really considered it a major occasion before.
Well, which one is it?
30th.
Oh, the 30th anniversary. That's a big one. What is the 30th?
How do you mean?
You know, the first one's paper, the 20th is china, the 25th is silver, the 30th must be...
Valium.
What would Drum save you to say that?
Nothing. He doesn't have any idea what Valium is. The man prides himself on never having any tension, which is amazing considering all that he has created over the years. Mm. Oh, listen to me. I gotta stop taking pot shots at Drum all the time. He's a good man. It's crazy, but he's a good man.
He seems to be behaving himself lately. He was most civil in the Piggly Wiggly yesterday. I was caught off guard and smiled before I could help myself.
You know, the most bizarre thing has happened. Drum and I seem to be finding all the things that brought us together in the first place. I don't know if we buried them or became blind to them.
Used to be, the thought of our parents being romantic made me and my brother sick to our stomach. But it's actually been a lovely week.
Every now and then, Drum and I seem to find these moments of magic. I don't know. I don't know if I'm lucky that I have what I have, or lucky to know what I have.
Well, that's too deep for me. I have to go get my tires rotated.
My turn.
Miss Ouiser?
Malin, maybe you should write a romance novel based on your recent experiences. I could help you with the dirty parts.
No one would believe it. Shelby, you're looking a little pale.
I'm fine, Mama.
How are you?
Well, ladies, if you're out and about this afternoon, stop on by the Dixie Plaza Shopping Center. The radio station is sponsoring a summer fiesta with lots of prizes and a live band. They call themselves Single Bullet Fairy.
Shelby! What have you done to yourself?
Oh, it doesn't hurt.
Malin! Have you seen this?
Yes, I have.
The doctor's just been trying to strengthen my veins. They're in terrible shape.
It looks like you've been driving nails into your arms. What is going on here?
Shall we tell him, Mama?
I suppose there's no point keeping it a secret any longer.
Shelby has been driving nails into her arms.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
So serious.
It's my dialysis.
What?
Dialysis. It's when...
We know what it is.
Please, honey, tell us what's going on.
It's no big thing. Not any big thing. Well, don't look at me like that.
Well, how long have you been doing this dialysis?
A couple months.
Mary Lynn Eanton, why wasn't I told? I'm without words.
There was no point. Sometimes you just don't want to talk about things.
What would have been the point? There's nothing that you could have done.
We could have done something. I can't believe you didn't say something. This is selfish. This is very selfish of you.
Hold it. Y'all talking like this is something.
This isn't something?
Having Jack Jr. put too much strain on my kidneys, and now they're kaput. That's all. The doctor said this will probably happen.
That's all. That's all she says.
I'm responding beautifully to dialysis. Do I look bad?
No, you look beautiful, but
Well, maybe you're going to let us in on what's going to happen.
Will you have to do this dialysis forever?
I suppose you could, but that's not real convenient when you're trying to keep up with a 15-month-old ball of fire. So, I'll just have a kidney transplant and I'll be fine.
Is it that easy?
Sure. They do them all the time in Shreveport, 3 or 4 a week.
They do. Our Sunday school class was praying for one just the other day.
But the hard part is finding the kidney, isn't it?
I saw something about it on the news. It's so dramatic. These medical teams fly all over the place taking hearts and kidneys and who knows what else. But you know what impressed me the most? They carry those organs in beer coolers.
Stop!
I would not lie in a moment as serious as this. Those doctors take out their six packs, throw in some dry ice and a heart, and get on the plane.
She's right.
But you never know when one will pop up, do you?
No, but I'm registered on the nationwide transplant computer.
Well, Shelby, how long do you have to wait?
There are people at dialysis who have been waiting for years.
That must be agony.
I suppose. But I'm lucky. I don't have to wait anymore. Mama's gonna give me one of her kidneys.
For heaven's sakes.
When? We check in tomorrow morning.
You're giving Shelby a kidney tomorrow and you haven't even mentioned it?
Truvy, I need my hair done. Can you please work on that?
I don't think I've ever been at a loss for words, but I think this is the time.
Listen, I'm just happy that it's me, okay? The boys are young. They would never, I would not want them to go through this. And who would want one of Drum's mean old organs anyway?
Oh, yes. Ain't that the truth?
But the best thing about all of this is that with all the tests and stuff, I've discovered I have the constitution of someone 10 years younger. How about that?
Must be so painful.
Not really for me. My operation's simple. But Mama's is awful. They basically have to saw her in half to get to the kidney. It's major, major surgery for her.
Malin, they have to saw you in half?
Well, they do it on Circus of the Stars all the time.
This is no laughing matter.
Listen. It'll make my waist smaller because they have to take my bottom ribs out to get my kidney out.
Cher had a rib taken out to make her waist smaller.
Yep. Please, that woman is out of her mind.
Listen, Shelby, earlier this morning I said I would be better off when my body wore out. I didn't mean that. You know better than to pay attention to anything I say.
Forget it, Miss Ouiser.
I'm a horrible person.
No.
No, you're not, Ouiser. You'd give your dog a kidney if he needed one.
Absolutely.
How are you two so calm and collected? I'm happy. Look at the opportunity I have. Most mothers only get the opportunity to give their child life once. I get to do it twice. I think it's neat. Shelby needs her help to chase after that rambunctious kid of hers. I've got two kidneys. I only need one.
I'm just happy we get to get it over with before it gets to be too hot.
Ain't that the truth?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to postpone my vacation a day so I can sit with your husband during the operation. I can run get Coca-Colas and things.
That's sweet, but please don't change your plans.
We'll make sure Drum has enough food.
Yes, put your house out of your mind. We will take care of everything.
I appreciate that. And Drum does, too.
Malin, you are brave. You are brave.
You know, Shelby, if I didn't know any better, I wouldn't know you'd ever been sick a day in your life.
That's the biggest compliment anybody has ever paid me.
Poor Shelby.
Don't say that. I have my baby, and I am very happy. If this is the price I have to pay, then I have to pay it. Now, if I'm not mistaken, somebody has a present to open.
Ooh, is this for me?
Only if you can wear a size 4.
I can take it in.
It's just a little something I picked up. Would you?
Oh, sure.
It was on sale, truthfully.
Ooh. Ooh. Ladies, do I look fabulous or what?
God bless you, Shelby.
Shelby, you're going to be the sassiest girl in that hospital.
Well, what about me?
You ladies better come visit.
I'll be right by your side when you wake up. Yours too, Malin. I'll manage it somehow.
And I will keep Drum calm during the operation.
We're in such good hands, Mama. You're going to be a while. I'm going to go back to the house and spend some time with Daddy.
It's a good idea. Drum isn't taking this very well. He gets so emotional over the least little thing.
Truly, I know this might gross you out, but could I have my hair? Is that too repulsive?
People do it all the time.
I guess I've had it for so long, it just represents an era or something.
Shelby, your nails.
Oh.
I'll put it in a box and give it to your mama.
Okay. I love you all. Oh, Miss Clairee. Would you do something for me?
Of course.
Next time you talk to Drew and Belle, I know they're upset about Marshall and all, but can you tell them I said that's the most disturbing thing that's ever happened to them? Then they should just get over it.
I'll tell them today.
Truvy, why isn't my radio playing?
Thank you.
might just have another state championship to call their own. That final way I scored again, 27-6. There's no new word on the lawsuit brought by the Reverend Q.T. Bennett against the Chinkfin Parish Board of Education. The Reverend, who is pastor of the Riverview Baptist Church, has filed suit charging that the use of the devil as a mascot for our high school team encourages satanic behavior in the youth of our community. When reached for comment about the Reverend's lawsuit, Devil's head coach Robbie Thibodeau said, and I quote, "Tell him to go to hell." My personal congratulations to my
I just can't today, honey. You know what? What about cool? Well, I can pitch in Monday morning. All right. I'll see you then, Susan.
Baton Rouge and a year's supply of plywood from Marmillion Mills, the finest plywood money can buy. If you're going out today, bundle up. We'll be doing good to get up to 39 degrees.
39 degrees. You were right, Truvy.
It's too cold for this time of year. I'm gonna write a letter.
I don't like it one bit. I turn blue when it's this cold, and blue is not in my palate.
Anne Boleyn had six fingers.
Who's Anne Boleyn?
Anne Boleyn. She was one of the six wives of Henry VIII.
Oh, I don't ever watch public television.
She had six fingers.
What happened to the other four?
She had 11 total.
Are you trying to confuse me? What are you talking about?
This article says she had six fingers on one hand, so she had all of her dresses made so the sleeves came down to her fingertips so she didn't look weird.
Reader's Digest is a font of useful information.
Clairee, I just love my scarf. It was so thoughtful of you to think of us. It really jazzes up my outfit.
Well, the only thing that separates us from the animals is our ability to accessorize.
And I just love my French perfume. I love it so much. I love it when the smell just fills the air.
Don't spray too much of that stuff, it ain't cheap.
Save it, honey. We're gonna have to burn our clothes as it is.
I am just so touched that you thought of us.
Well, I had a ball shopping. I don't care what anyone says, the French people are very friendly. And most of them have the courtesy to speak English.
Oh, and I really like Ouiser's too. I might have to borrow this.
You're welcome to it.
You don't like it, do you?
Oh, it's perfect for me. A print this busy will cover up the dog hair.
My feet are like two blocks of ice.
This coffee tastes like it was made in a rubber tire.
Annelle, remember to get that new thing for the Mr. Coffee.
Have any of you seen her this morning?
I haven't. I went directly to the house when I got in. Only the boys were there.
Do you think she'll come by?
I doubt it. I'm sure her hair is the farthest thing from her mind.
Well, we don't know what's on her mind, and I just wanted to be here for her in case she needed something.
I'm glad you decided to stay open today.
How are the boys?
As well as can be expected.
My husband and I are taking some barbecue over there later.
I have never seen so much food.
You can never have enough at times like these. My husband's back at the apartment cooking up a storm. He's convinced his red beans and rice will make everyone feel better.
Well, maybe he's right. That's why they call it soul food. I might need to get that recipe.
You'll have to ask him. Sammy runs me out of the kitchen whenever he starts cooking. That kitchen is so small he's scared he'll hit me in the stomach with a spatula.
When are you moving, Annelle?
Next month.
You had to bring that up. She's moving right when I'm about to become a semi-grandmother.
It's just down the street, Truvy. A hop, skip, and a jump. That apartment is so squunged, Sammy and I have to step outside to change our minds. You're toying with me, aren't you?
A little, not a lot. Well, I guess it's just me and the old man.
Truvy, be thankful. You'd miss him if he were gone.
You know, last night, he actually got up off the couch and said, "Do you want to go out to dinner?" Well, after I came to, I thought Deputy Dog had been preempted. And then he said he had a good chance of getting the electrical contract at the new college library. Oh. I'm not supposed to tell anyone.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome back, Clairee. How was Paris?
Totally beautiful. I ate too much. I bought you something pretty.
Oh, you shouldn't have. Thank you. Oh, don't turn off Shelby's radio. I like the noise.
this special programming today. I had Jonathan go down to the station and pull music that Shelby would have liked. He's going to play it till noon.
He told me. I think you'll be surprised at some of the things you're going to hear.
Well, that's okay. It's for Shelby.
Malin, just tell us. What can we do?
Shelby, do you think, or Truvy, do you think you could work a little magic on my hair? I think I must look like 10 miles of dirt road.
Let me get my wand and my fairy dust. Honey, how you doing?
Well, I'm fine. I'm a little worried about Drum. Boys got in last night. I'm not really sure how they're doing. Jackson is Jackson, I guess. You know, he has his hands full with Jack Jr. I will admit, it is hard to be somber with a baby line running around.
Lynn, I'm beside myself. Wasn't Shelby fine when I left? Can you talk about it?
Sure. Basically, after the transplant failed, she went back on dialysis. I mean, you knew that. And she'd been doing fine the past couple of months, until suddenly on Monday, everything went wrong. It was like dominoes. So they thought they could correct things with a little bit of surgery. And when they were wheeling her down, she said, "Mama, I'm gonna feel so good when this is all over." Then they gave her the anesthetic, and
in a way, she was right. Maybe she knew she was going to be with her cane.
Sure, now I suppose so.
We should be rejoicing.
Well, you go on ahead. I wish I could feel the same way. I guess I'm a little selfish. I'd rather have it here.
Oh, Miss Malin, I don't mean to hurt you by saying that. You see, when something like this happens, I pray very hard to make heads or tails of it. I think in Shelby's case, she wanted to take care of that baby, of you, of everybody she knew. And her poor body was just worn out. It wouldn't let her do everything she wanted to do. So she went on to a place where she could be a guardian angel. She will always be young, and she will always be beautiful. And I personally feel much safer knowing she's up there on my side. I know that may sound real simple and stupid to some people, and maybe I am, but that's just how I get through things like this.
Thank you, Annelle. I appreciate that. And it's a real good idea. Shelby, as you know, would not want us to get all mired down and wallow in this. She would just look at this as one of life's little occurrences. We should deal with it the best way we know how and get on with it. That's what my mind says. I just wish someone would explain it to my heart.
Thomas said you didn't leave her side.
Didn't leave my Shelby. You know, it's interesting. Both boys were very difficult births. I almost died when I had Jonathan. Such difficult births. Shelby was a breeze. I could have gone home that afternoon I had her. I kept thinking about that as I was sitting next to Shelby while she was in a coma. I'd work our arms and legs to keep the circulation going. I told the ICU nurse we were doing Aunt Jane Fonda. Just sat there and kept on pushing, just like I always have when Shelby's concerned. Kept hoping she'd sit up and argue with me or something. But finally we realized there was no hope. At that moment I panicked. I was very afraid that I was not going to be able to get through the next few minutes while they turned off the machines. Drum couldn't take it. He left. Jackson couldn't take it. He left. I find it amusing. Men are supposed to be made out of steel or something. But I couldn't leave. I just sat there, holding Shelby's hands while the sounds got softer and the beeps got farther apart, until all was quiet. There's no noise, no tremble, just peace. I realize as a woman how lucky I am. I was there when that wonderful person drifted into my world, and I was there when she drifted out. God, it was the most precious moment of my life.
Well, honey, I don't know how your insides are doing, but your hair's holding up beautifully. All it needs is a lick and a promise. And did you have it done in Shreveport?
No, I did it myself.
Oh, I don't want to hear that kind of talk.
I'm doing my own hair, was all it. I had no idea about the back.
Well, you did a wonderful job. I just smoothed up the rough patches. In fact, I'm going to be looking for some help when Annelle goes on maternity leave. Are you interested?
Just with all that was going on, I didn't know if I would even feel like coming in or if I would have time. But I woke up this morning and I wanted to be here more than anything in the entire world. Is that silly?
No.
You know, I went into Shelby's closet last night to get something. You know what I found? All of our Christmas presents. Stacked up, wrapped, with their own two hands. I gotta go.
Yeah. Check the back.
It's perfect as usual. Shelby's right. It does kind of look like a football.
Honey, please sit back down. Sit right back down. Are you all right?
Oh, boy.
Oh.
I'm fine. I can jog all the way to Texas and back. But my daughter can't. She never could. God, I'm so mad. I don't know what to do. I want to know why. I want to know why Shelby's life is over. How is that baby ever going to understand how wonderful his mother was? Will he ever understand what she went through for him? God, I don't even understand. Lord, I wish I could. No, it is not supposed to happen this way. I'm supposed to go first. I've always been ready to go first. God, I can't take this. I just want to hit somebody until they feel as bad as I do. I just want to hit something, and I want to hit it hard.
You!
Hit this!
Are you crazy? Are you high?
What, Clairee? Have you lost your mind?
This is all T-shirt saying, I slapped Ouiser but don't hit her!
Truvy, dial 911!
Don't let her beauty stand in the way. Hit her!
Miss Clairee, enough!
Ouiser, this is your chance to help your fellow man.
Knock her lights out, Malin!
Clairee, you're gonna piss off God if you're not careful.
Let go of me!
Well, Malin, you just missed a chance of a lifetime. Most of Chicopin Parish would give their eye teeth to take a whack at Ouiser.
You are a pig from hell.
All right. Okay, hit me then. I deserve it.
Whatever would we do without Clary's own special brand of humor?
Clairee, you are evil and must be destroyed.
Mm-hmm. Darling, Mother Nature is taking care of that faster than you ever could. Things were getting entirely too serious there for a minute. I'm sorry, Malin. We're all entitled to our sorrow.
It was really funny, Clairee.
I have to admit I laughed, even though that was not a very Christian thing to do, Miss Clairee.
Annelle, honey, you're going to have to lighten up.
My husband says the same thing.
I bet Lloyd got a kick out of that one.
Lloyd always did get a lot of enjoyment at my expense when he was alive.
Malin, you know how much Lloyd adored Shelby. I'm sure he's up there right now, showing her around, fixing her speeding tickets.
Shelby did really adore him.
She worshipped the quicksand he walked on. And I'm sure when Shelby got up there, he was very happy to see a familiar face. He was a Louisiana politician. We don't know that many people that went to heaven.
Clairee.
Ouiser, you know I love you more than my luggage.
You are too twisted for color TV.
Well, thank you.
Well, now that you two have made up, we need to let this woman go. She cannot be a pillar of strength with her eye makeup running down her neck.
I shouldn't have gone on the way I did. I'm sorry. Everybody cry.
Don't be silly. Laughter through tears is my favorite emotion.
Perhaps I should have an outburst more often. Maybe I'll start having them at home. Jerome would be so pleased. I'm so glad I came in here today. Shelby would have had a good time.
I'm sure she did.
Malin, tell your family, especially Drum, that they are in my prayers. Yes, Annelle, I pray. There, I said it. Are you satisfied?
I have suspected this all along.
But don't go trying to get me to go to your church to one of those tent revivals with all those Bible beaters doing God only knows what. They'd probably make me eat a lot of chicken.
Not on your first visit.
Oh, very good, Annelle. Spoken like a true smartass.
Malin, Owen wanted me to tell you that you are in his thoughts.
Well, I didn't think that you and Owen
He's coming in on Monday to take me to Shelby's service. That girl would do anything to get us together.
Well, I better go.
Malin, you just give us a call if you need anything. You hear?
If her line's busy, you call me.
Call me. I have call waiting.
Oh, Miss Malin, I've been meaning to tell you that Sammy and I decided that if this is a girl, we want to name it Shelby, since she's the reason we met in the first place, if you don't mind.
Mind? Shelby would love that. I'm tickled pink. Oh, pink.
What do you name it if it's a boy?
Shelby, I guess.
As it should be, life goes on.
Malin, I know it's hard, but things will get better. And if you feel like taking a whack at something, come on in here and hit on me. I won't break.
I might take you up on that offer. You all have no idea how wonderful you are.
Of course we do.